Today, we're here to talk about the Garmin Tacx NEO 3M Smart Trainer, and I have Bobby here to explain a little bit more about it. Let's start by opening this up and see what's in the box. All right, Bobby, we got everything out here. This is all that's in the box. Tell me a little about what we have here.
All right, well, to start off, we obviously have your Tacx NEO 3M trainer.
Yep.
We've got the new wheel riser block, which now is flippable and has different size for different width tires.
Fantastic.
So compatible with more bikes. Your power cable here, you've got your little goodie bag of accessories for installing your bike. We'll go through those a little bit later.
Yep.
You've got a card here for a free 90-day subscription to the Tacx Training app premium features.
Okay.
So cool, be sure not to lose that. And then you've got some other documentation, your quick start manual and some important safety information. In the quick start manual, we now on the very first page have a QR code that you can scan, and that walks you right through all your setup in the Tacx Training app, makes it super simple.
All right, now let's talk about the trainer. So we've done some really cool things with this. The first thing I noticed, and I think a lot of people are gonna notice, is there's a cassette on this trainer. We haven't done that before, have we?
No, this is the first time that our trainer has come with a cassette out of the box. The cassette that we've chosen to include is an 11-speed Shimano and SRAM compatible cassette.
Okay.
Should work with a lot of the bikes on the market. If you do have one of the less common drivetrains and need a different cassette, mm-hmm. we offer multiple different cassette bodies for Campagnolo or Shimano Micro Spline or any of the other various drivetrains on the market. If you need any help with how to install those or get your a different cassette on the trainer, you can refer back to our NEO2T video that we made. We explained that pretty well.
Fantastic. And a couple other big things I noticed here. One, when you were getting this out of the box, we added a handle, and that's pretty great for portability, moving this around. We'll talk about the power cable and using this without that a little bit later, but tell me a little bit about the handle.
I mean, it's a handle.
It's a handle.
But it's sure. But it makes it a lot easier to move around.
Yeah, absolutely.
So I'm definitely glad to have it, and I'll take my trainer more places because of it, I think.
Yeah, absolutely. The next big one, motion. Motion was something we spent a lot of time on figuring out how to integrate it into the trainer. On the NEO2T, we offer the motion plate separate, but here we have the ability to unlock and lock the motion, as well as we have some side-by-side motion. Tell me a little bit about that.
Yeah, this is basically the same technology that we have in our motion plates, just now with the convenience, you don't have to take them on and off, you can just simply turn that motion on or off. And then combined with the trainer already has designed flex so that you have side-to-side flex when you're on the bike, and pairing that with the front and back motion just gives you that all-around realistic ride feel.
So Bobby, this is the Tacx NEO 3M. Is this just a standard direct drive trainer? What's up with the whole NEO thing? Can you tell me a little bit more about that?
Yeah, absolutely. So this is the third trainer in the NEO lineup, the third iteration. They are called NEO because they use NEO technology, which is named that way because it has 32 neodymium magnets actually around this flywheel.
Okay.
So very cool technology. Not only is it direct drive, meaning you don't need a rear wheel, but it's also you're directly driving the motor of the trainer. There's no belt in this trainer.
Okay.
So that eliminates a lot of the noise. Belts can be a source of noise in trainers sometimes.
So I'm not gonna be waking up my family in the early hours in the morning.
Very, very quiet.
Okay.
And then the NEO technology also gives you some additional features like the ability to train without being plugged in.
Okay.
The motor can actually generate its own power because the whole trainer is basically an electromotor.
Interesting. So that's where people are before big rides or races. I see them on a trainer. It'd be something with the NEO technology in there.
Exactly. You can take it with you to the race, sit it next to your car, don't worry about plugging in, and get your warm-up in.
Wow, okay.
Very, very cool. It has some cool additional features. One of those is the real road feel.
Okay.
So it can pulse the motor and simulate different road conditions, which I don't know how they figured out how to do that, but it feels very, very real. It can simulate gravel or ice or wooden planks. I think dirt roads, there are multiple different surfaces that it can make you feel like you're riding outside.
Wow, okay, so that mixed with all the motion in here, it's gonna give you a pretty realistic ride experience.
Yeah, it's the most I've ever felt like I'm riding outside when I'm on the trainer.
Wow, that makes a big difference.
Very, very cool. Also has a feature called the scent simulation, where if you're on a virtual ride and going down a hill and you stop pedaling, your bike's gonna accelerate just like you're going down a hill outside. So very, very, very cool technology.
All right, Bobby, what do I need to know to get my bike on this trainer?
Honestly, not a lot. It's a pretty simple setup. It is a little different than the NEO2T though, so we can go through it. We now have axle end caps like we did before, but then also axle adapters for each of the end caps. So you need to find the end cap that works for your bike and then the axle adapter that works for your axle.
Okay.
So the end caps that come on the trainer out of the box are compatible with 135 millimeter quick release axles or 142 millimeter through axle axles.
And how would I know which one my bike has or?
So you should be able to find that information on the axle from your bike. Okay. Usually they'll have it written on there. If it's not there, the manufacturer's website or your local bike shop should be able to help you out.
Perfect.
If you do need to change out the axle adapter, say you have a 130 millimeter quick release bike or you have a 148 millimeter boost through axle, we included a little tool here that works on these end caps, real easy to take off, and they just thread right on there. They don't need to be super tight. And then once you have the end caps on that you need to find your adapters. The bike we're gonna be mounting is 142 millimeter through axle. So we've got the 142 millimeter through axle adapters, and then you don't need a tool for these, they just pop right in.
All right, Bobby, so now we have the axle all figured out. Is there anything we need to do with the motion plates or the front end here? Like, what do we need to do before we get the bike on, or is it ready to go?
Yeah, I do think the best practice is to start with your motion plates locked out. So I would make sure that these are locked and that your trainer is set on locked motion plates. That makes sure everything is aligned.
Okay.
So then when you do unlock them, everything works smoothly and quietly.
Perfect.
Yeah, so once that's locked out and those are set, then we can grab the bike and get it mounted. So once the bike is mounted, there are also lines here that you'll notice on the front wheel riser. So you get it on the appropriate side for your tire width, and then these lines here indicate where the tire should sit when the trainer is just neutral.
Okay, and that will allow it to freely move forward and back.
Yes.
I'm gonna go ahead and unlock this just to give it a little demo.
Okay, yeah, we can take a look there.
We'll see how it rolls. Oh yeah, that's slick.
So we've got the bike all set up. Now all that's left to do is connect the trainer to the Tacx Training app and get ready to ride. Reminder again, there's a QR code now on your documentation that came in the box. It'll take you right to your onboarding process, walks you through all of the setup for the app. And then also don't forget to go and redeem the voucher code so that you can do 90 days of those premium features. That's gonna get you access to the full library of videos, training plans, challenges, there are group rides. So definitely some stuff you're gonna wanna check out.
Yeah, it's gonna make the indoor riding experience way better.
Way, way better. And then if you're someone that does a lot of racing or is really, really serious about your indoor riding, we also have a new accessory for this that will allow you to connect the trainer directly to the internet via Wi-Fi or an Ethernet connection. Okay. Just to give you a faster, super reliable connection if you're online racing or doing things like that.
All right, Bobby, thank you for being here, man. Thank you for going through this whole setup process. It seems way simpler, and we're excited to go get some miles in.
Yeah, it's time to ride the trainer.
Let's do it.